Welcome back, everybody. As we continue to talk about basic concepts in statistics, this time let's take a few minutes to talk about summation notation. This table right here provides us with an opportunity to practice. You'll see that on the next page, the solutions are already listed, so you can easily check your work. In another video that I've already posted, I've already taught you how to do summation notation in 3 easy steps. So if you haven't watched this video right here, make sure that you do. And what we're going to do right now is practice. So let's do that. Let's practice. In this particular set of examples, we have 2 variables, life events, which is labeled X, and behavioral problems, labeled Y. Regardless of what those variables represent, for right now, we're really just focusing on the math, the specific steps that we need to follow to compute each equation. This first equation asks us to sum up X, sigma X. Here's our X variable, and it's actually already summed up for us. So that one's pretty easy, 56. The next one as well is already done for us, sigma Y, that's the sum of Y. Do we have a column labeled Y? We do, we should sum it up. All those values sum up to 12. This particular one right here is asking us for the sum of X squared. So we need to ask ourselves, sum up what? Well, we need to sum up all of the squared x values. So here we have a column of x values. Let's create a column for squared x values. We take things one step at a time, so now let's take each one of those values and square them. 10 squared is 100, 15 squared is 225, 12 squared is 144, 9 squared is 81, 10 squared is 100. All right, so that was step 2. We created a column and we squared all of our values. Now we need to kind of flirt with step 3, determine if we're ready for step 3. So we need to ask ourselves, do we have a column labeled with what we've been asked to sum up? And we do. We've been asked to sum up squared x values. We have a column labeled x squared, so now it's time to sum it up. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's get a little bit of help from our calculator. We've got 100 plus 225 plus 144 plus 81 plus 100. That equals 650. All right, let's move on to the next one, the sum of y squared. Here we have a column of y values. What we're being asked to sum up are squared y values. So we ask ourselves, do we need to add a column? And we do. So for step 2, we're going to create a column labeled y squared. Of course, now what we want to do is square each one of these y values. 3 squared is 9, 4 squared is 16, 1 squared is 1, 1 squared again is 1, and 3 squared is 9. All right, now we need to determine if we might be ready for step 3. So we ask ourselves, do we have a column labeled with what we've been asked to sum up? And we do. So we should go ahead with step 3, and we should sum up that column. 9 and 16 is 25, 26, 27. 27 and 9 would be 36. So the sum of y squared is 36. Let's take a look at the next one. This is asking for the sum of the quantity x minus y. So we need to ask ourselves, what are we being asked to sum up? This is saying take every x value, subtract every y value, and once you have a column of those different scores, then sum them up. So as we look up here, we have to ask ourselves, what column would we like to add? Well, we should add a column that contains x values minus y values. So for step 2, we created that column, and now we're going to do all the subtraction that's necessary. 10 minus 3 is 7. 15 minus 4 is 11. 12 minus 1 is 11. 9 minus 1 is 8. 10 minus 3 is 7. Now that we're done with step 2, we see if we're ready for step 3. We ask ourselves, do we have a column labeled with what we've been asked to sum up? And we do. So we are ready for step 3. So all we need to do now is sum up that column. 7 and 11 is 18, 28, 29, 37. 37 and 7 would be 44. 44. All right, let's move on to the next example. This is the sum of xy. It's the sum of x times y. So in step one, we ask ourselves, sum up what? We need to sum up the x's times the y's. So we have a column of x values, y values. In step two, we'll create a column labeled x times y. And then we'll multiply all of the x's times their associated y values. So we've got 10 times 3, which would be 30. 15 times 4, which is 60. 12 times 1 is 12. 9 times 1 is 9. 10 times 3 is 30. So that was step 2. Now we want to see if we're ready for step 3. We ask ourselves, do we have a column labeled with what we've been asked to sum up? And we do. So we're ready for step 3. We should sum up that column. 30 and 60 is 90. That's 102, 111, 141. 141. In this next one, we have the sum of x, that quantity squared. We already know the sum of x. It's equal to 56. So we need to take that quantity and square it. So we have 56 squared. Let's figure out what that equals. $3,136. Looks like the next one is similar. Here we have the sum of y, that quantity, squared. Well, we already know the sum of y equals 12, so we need to square that quantity. So we need 12 squared, and 12 squared is 144. Let's look at the next one. This has the sum of the quantity x minus y, that entire quantity squared. We already know the sum of the quantity x minus y because we computed that right here. This is the sum of the quantity x minus y. This is saying take that entire value and square it. So we have 44 squared. Let's see what that equals. $1,936. And finally, we need the sum of x, that quantity, multiplied by the sum of y, that quantity. Well, we already know the sum of x, and we already know the sum of y. We need to take this quantity and multiply by this quantity. So we have 56 multiplied by 12, using parentheses to show multiplication. So let's figure it out. 56 times 12 equals 672. So that's basic summation notation, my friends. Make sure you practice, make sure you become comfortable with it. It's not going away. We're going to be using it all semester long. If you have any questions at all, just let me know. Take care. I'll see you in the next video. Be safe.